Good morning. Lots of good conversations going on. I didn't want to interrupt, so. Welcome to those of you who are here in person or those who are worshiping with us online. We have a special service today, a service of lessons and carols. So thank you for choosing to worship at New Promise. If you are a guest today, thank you again for you. We're glad you're here. There are some yellow cards in the chair pockets for guests. If you would like to fill that out and take that. Are they green? Thank you. They change color for this season, I forget. If you take that to the welcome window just across the way, there is a gift in exchange for that. Know that you're invited to participate fully in our service today, including communion. Just a quick word about how we do communion here. As you come forward in two lines for communion, there are empty cups here at the head of the aisle. Those are for wine. If you prefer grape juice, they are in pre-filled cups held by the acolyte. And as you cycle through, you'll receive gluten-free bread and then receive a blessing, regardless of which kind you get. And then cups can be left at the baskets on the side aisles as you cycle around to your seats. Also, there are prayer cards in the pockets there. If you'd like to leave a prayer for the community or just with the pastors, you're certainly welcome to fill that out and leave that in the offering basket. A couple of events coming up. We have the First Friday. This is a kids' event. This happens on the 5th and 19th in January for grades K through 5. And if you'd like to participate in that, text Pat or Jill and just let her know you'll be coming. Also, we have a winter youth activity coming up, dodgeball. This is going to be the current youth against former New Promise youth. So we have to look forward to that. That is January 12th at 7 p.m. Our support groups will be starting up again on January 15th. We have gone through the grief support and the divorce care. We've gone through one session. We're going to start it again on the 15th. So I hope folks for whom that might be helpful would think about attending that. The annual meeting is coming up on the 28th, and that will be on Zoom, not Zom. This will be for folks to come to in person, but also will be available on Zoom. We'll be holding that in the fellowship hall for those who come in person. If you would like to submit a resolution to be presented at the annual meeting, those need to be submitted in writing ahead of time. So the due date for those is the 15th of January. Pastor Katie is going to be starting Disciples Journey again. This is a class she's done once, and it's very popular, and she's offering it again beginning January 30th. This is a Tuesday. It'll be held at 6:30 and runs for 6 weeks. There is a sign-up for that at the information desk, so I invite you to check that out. If you want to know more about that, you can talk to Pastor Katie. And then lastly, we have a flower chart that is up, both for flowers and the eternal flame. If you want to sign up for flowers on that Sunday to commemorate an event or in memory of someone or in thanksgiving of something, please check that out and sign up for whatever date you choose. Lastly, we've had a few deaths in the congregation just this past week. Judy Richards passed away. She's been a member for many years. And then also Enid Hauer passed away. So I invite you to keep their families in prayer. I also heard today that Joan Van Olen, who was a former member of the church, has been living the last 5 or 6 years, I think, maybe even more, in Texas, but she also passed away. So we'll keep her family in prayer. That's it for our announcements. I invite the congregation to stand and face the baptismal font as we continue with the confession and forgiveness.
We face the baptismal font as a reminder of God's promise to forgive us in the waters of baptism. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, love from the beginning, word made flesh, breath of heaven. Amen. Let's say, confess our sinfulness before God and one another. Let's take a moment to reflect on those things for which we come seeking forgiveness today. Merciful God, we confess that we are not perfect. We have said and done things we regret. We have tried to earn your redeeming grace while denying it to others. We have resisted your call to be your voice in the world. Forgive us, loving God. Give us your righteousness, the strength to put aside our failures, and the courage to try again. Amen. Dear people of God, hear the good news. Christ the Savior is born. You are loved and you are forgiven in the name of Jesus Christ who has come among us. You are freed from proving that you deserve to be loved because God's love is given to you as the most precious gift of all. Rejoice in this love and share it with the world. Amen. The bright morning star shines light in the world. By day and night, he shines for all to see. Jesus was born in the midst of injustice and poverty, that the world may see the justice and richness of God. God so loved the world that he sent Jesus, so that all who believe in him may not perish, but have eternal life. Jesus is the light of the world. Jesus is the light of our lives. Sing to God a new song, a song of hope, joy, and peace around the world. You may be seated.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Gracious God of heaven and earth, you have thrown a lifeline to us in our darkness, a beam of light that shines through Jesus. Though born in a manger, he is the firstborn of all creation. Though crucified on a cross, He is the Lord of life. Fill us with the wonder and joy of his presence in the world and in our hearts. Amen. The first reading is from Genesis chapter 1. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them be signs for the seasons, and for the days, and for the years. And let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth." And it was so. God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good.
Second reading from the book of Micah. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace.
Thank you.
Our third reading is from Luke chapter 1. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, for I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you, and therefore the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Reading from the Gospel of Matthew. Now the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they had lived together, She was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet, "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus.
Fifth reading is from Luke chapter 2. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I'm bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth among those whom he favors. When the angels had left them and gone back into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known what they had been told about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told to them.
Sixth reading from the Gospel of St. Matthew. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage. When King Herod heard of this, he was frightened. And all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophets. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel. Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring word to me so that I may also go and pay him homage. When they had heard the king, they set out. There ahead of them went the star, that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage, then opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Our seventh reading is from John chapter 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life. And the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness does not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God. Who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Let's pray together a Christmas prayer. It is you, loving God, who lights our path with truth. Your word, Jesus, is truth. In his light, draw all to the manger to gather in wonder with the shepherds. In his light, draw all to the manger to kneel in reverence with the wise ones. In his light, draw all to the manger to sing for joy with the angels. In the brightness of his life, cast away the darkness of injustice, poverty, and hunger in the world. It is you, loving God, who meets us on our way. In the light of Jesus, show the world the way of life. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you all. Let's share a sign of peace with one another. I invite you to stand as we bring forth our gifts and offerings. Let us pray. God, our Redeemer, receive and bless these gifts we have offered. Join our hearts with the song of the angels and gather us at your table of celebration. Strengthen us to share with all the world the abundance of your grace upon grace. poured out in Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, for in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, broke it, gave thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Now gathered into one by the power of the Holy Spirit, let's pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. And now, the Word who's made flesh is here again for us at this table. I invite you all to be seated.
Thank you.
for you.
Praise God, from whom all blessings flow.
Praise God, all creatures here below.
You are the shepherds telling the story.
We tell it in the streets and across the land.
You are the wise ones worshiping with thanksgiving.
We worship with gifts of song and service, talents and treasures.
You are the angels announcing peace. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen.
Amen.